I do like the idea of a leader, something that leads the eye through. So this dotted line and the inspiration for the dotted line, turn off my text layer. I love this idea. So I think I will use the dotted line to have my text, have a visual path through my text. I'm going to delete this old one because I don't know where my text is going to be yet. Okay, so let's turn off the inspiration piece. Okay, and we're going to look at this text. Now, I might shorten this copy block. It's a little long. Okay, let's see how short I can go without it being a problem. There we go. Whoops, I want to conform to the grid. There we are. And I'm going to lift this up just a little bit. So I'm just kind of moving this first initial box around. Now, I might want my experience here, but I might want it staggered. So sometimes what I'll do is I'll go ahead and shorten this box. I'm hitting the W key every once in a while. Now, if I really wanted to, I could break this into more columns, but that gets kind of confusing. And I want, maybe I do want to stagger some stuff, but the thing of it is, I can't find my text. Well, if I hit the plus sign if I click on it with the selection tool, the little plus sign indicates there is more text past the bounding box. So I click on it and I get a loaded cursor again. So I'm going to just click and drag. And I'm like, you know, that looks nice, but I really don't care for the way it's so scrunched up. So I'm going to move it down a little bit. There we go. I'm going to have that bit of experience go over here to the right. Now again, I'm going to click on this box and I'm going to close it up. Now you do have to really be careful about spacing. Watch your spacing when you do stuff like this. Make sure that you have equal amount of space between the lines. Now this still has extra type, more type, so I'm going to click and drag. Got a little carried away there, a little too high. And this goes across three columns. And let's see, I believe there's more information here. There we go. Now, every once in a while, I might want to look at my Word document. And my initial Word document looks like it was here. That was the one with the, paragraph styles. Now, I did have these bullet pointed in my initial document, and I do like the bullet points, so I'm glad I revisited this. I may have to do some changing of some things that I had done earlier. So I may have to create a paragraph style with bullet pointed text. So I'm going to highlight all this, and there is a bullet point option. There it is. The only problem is, darn it, I took out all my hard returns. No, I didn't. I assumed before I knew what I was doing. Whoops, I just hit the space bar. Let me not do that. Okay, so I'm going to go back to type and show hidden characters. Actually, they are showing. And I've got to figure out what it is that I've got going on. What has gone awry. So let me go back to my original resume. And here I have three bullet pointed objects. Let me zoom out a little bit. And this should be three bullet pointed objects, unless this has come in improperly. Software developer to marketing promotion. Okay. Software develop marketing promotion specialized. Oh, well, there we go. I didn't even put a return there. So I'm going to hit return. Darn it. There we go. I also have this soft return, and I'm going to just hit return. And I'm getting text to wrap something fierce. Oops. Zoom out, click on this box. And so I had three bullet pointed objects. Now, here's the problem. These are all based off of the paragraph style called body copy. Okay? Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on this one. All one, two, three, four. Whoops. There we go. It grabs the whole paragraph. And I'm going to go ahead and take out the space after, put that as a zero. And I am going to create a new paragraph style from this bulleted text. So I'm going to come down to my paragraph style. I'm going to click on New Paragraph Style. It automatically names it Paragraph Style 1, 2, or 3. Double click on it. And I'm going to call it Bulleted Text and hit OK. Now all I have to do is grab all three of those bullets and just tell it, hey, you are bulleted text. Now, the space after is gone, but considering that I'm staggering these, that's not a big deal. Okay? Now I have to deal with the rest of this. Whoops. So I'm going to take out every hard return or soft return, put in a hard return. I just hit the return key. I'm going to highlight these things and I'm going to tell them they are bulleted text. And then I'm going to bring my bounding box up. So this is a lot of surgery when you're working from Microsoft Word to InDesign or back again. And this is something that through time you get better with and you become more efficient and quicker at. But when you're newer to it, there's all sorts of little things that you have to alter. So about the time you think you've got it, well, it acts otherwise. So I'm going to go ahead and just take care of a lot of these all right now. See, this was bulleted text. And down here, I'm not ready for that yet because it's getting off the pasteboard. So I'll deal with that when I get to it. Guess I should zoom in. See where I'm going next. Okay. So here we have our profile, our experience. Experience is staggered. I could even stagger this a little differently. I might stagger it like so. So it's more of a stair step type thing. The only bad thing is I really got to watch my space. And again, this is something I would probably have to measure for because I want to make sure there's equal amount of space between these. Now, another thing I've seen folks do is I've seen them stagger and then come back like so, which I think I had earlier. But right now it just looks a little weird because the top of this doesn't feel right. Okay, so I may have to. What I think I will do, I don't like to do this. Well, on a resume, it's not that big a deal. I might go ahead and copy or cut this text. Get rid of the extra returns. Let me move this text box back down so it ends up only showing what I wanted it to. And then I can create a text box for my profile stuff and paste it. Command V or Control B, V, Control V as in Victor on a PC. There we go. Now it is completely independent of the other ones. In other words, we don't have to worry about text flow. Okay, so my profile is getting a little longer. These are a little shorter. So I'm actually going for visual hierarchy here. And a little semblance of order. Plus, I'm trying to tighten up some space. Alrighty. I do have a little trap white space there, so I'm not going to have that. So let's go ahead and maybe stagger it this way. Now I'm ready for the next bit of text, which I believe was education. So let me grab the or click on the little plus sign, reload my cursor. I'm going to click and drag and see what all I still have left to do. So I have education and skills. Now it feels as if I'm running out of space, and this is pretty common when you're working on your designs that space becomes a little harder to work with, so I'm going to reduce the size of this name. Have it be about as wide as the address I have here. Bring the address up. By the way, I keep hitting the W key so I can get rid of all those lines. And let me widen this a little bit so it can just kind of hug down inside. Excuse me. Shift and Command, click and drag. So what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to get the address to kind of fit down below the word Jane, there we go. Just a nice little comfortable nudging. Move profile up. Move all these experience lists up. I'm just using the arrow keys on the keyboard. If you hold down shift, it goes a lot faster. It goes in larger increments. Okay, I might move some of this stuff up a little bit. Don't worry, I'm going to get the little directional in here soon. And then now I'm back here looking at the education information. Now, if I stick to the grid, it's conceivable that my education, what I've written, is this long. And that's fine, as long as it works and it looks good. I'm not sure that it looks good. Let me crop this. Maybe I'll put it down here a little bit, get some white space around it. So I just hit the W key and you can see I now have photography. So be careful about when you're hitting the W key, be careful and make sure you're in a different any tool other than the text box, or the type tool rather. And the last one would be skills. So let me click on this. Hello. There we go. Loaded cursor. Get my skills in here. Okay. Might be able to tighten this up a little bit. I might go half column on that. I can pull a guide, but we'll see how it goes. And I also might look at these bullet points and see if I should align to those bullet points. Good point of alignment right there. So this one might be an alignment that's kind of by eye. All right. Now this might take some finessing, but right now it looks not too bad. I'm gonna go to the layers panel. I'm really kind of not liking what's going on with that profile. It's kind of crowding out the address and stuff. So I'm going to kind of play around with this. Get that to fit a little bit nicer up top. Oops, don't want the scissors tool. There we go. So just a little finessing here and there. And this really isn't lined up well or clotheslining with education. So I might play around with that a little bit more. Try to get these to align a little bit better. Let me hit the W key. So you want to work with the grids turned on. I've got stuff kind of not snapping to the grid now. There we go. You want your columns to, your copy blocks usually to align to the grid lines. Sometimes I'll break the grid, but most of the time you want to keep with it. So now what I'm wanting to do is I'm wanting to align these two boxes, skills and education, because in my opinion it might just look better. Now I do have some dead trap space here and here, but if I get some graphics in there, it won't hurt. It'll help it out. Now, I also might have a graphic here. Not sure what yet, but I also have the opportunity to put an infographic. So lots of opportunities here.